You don't even know. Hey guys, welcome back. So I've noticed on YouTube there are a lot of videos talking about my psycho ex-boyfriend, and I haven't found any videos of my psycho ex-girlfriends. So I thought, hey, I got one of those. So we dated for 2 years, and it was magical. In the beginning of our relationship, she wasn't psycho until the end. That's when she started to become really jealous with every girl I talked to, even my mom. Like, if I talked to my mom too long, she would, like, hate on my mom, and that's my mom. She was also really jealous of my girl best friend. Let's call her Missy. And me and Missy have been friends way before I've met my ex. We were friends since middle school. And every time I talk to Missy, my ex will tell me, "You're cheating on me with her. You guys have something on the down low." And she will break up with me all the time. It was so freaking annoying. And then she would expect a big production for me to ask her back out. My other best friend at the time, let's call him Brutus, he would tell me, "Yo man, you really need to break up. Your guys' relationship is unhealthy. She's toxic, she's petty." He would go on and on about it. So, fast forward to the end of the relationship, Missy called me about her boyfriend, like she was also in a long-term relationship. So my ex found out she called me, and she lost it. She got pissed, and she broke up with me. Again, she broke up with me right before I was gonna go on this family trip for 1 week. So when I was gone, my best friend Brutus made out with my girl during that time, and that broke my heart in millions of pieces. I never felt true betrayal until that moment. He was my best friend, guys. I held him when he cried, yo. You don't even understand. And I couldn't believe that he could do that to me because I trusted him completely. So I called her up and I asked her, "Why? Why did you make out with Brutus, my best friend, 1 week after our breakup?" And she told me, "You hang out with Missy all the time. Why can't I hang out with Brutus?" That's not the same thing. I never made out with Missy. What gives you the right to make out with Brutus? Well, now you know how I feel. What do you, what the, I don't know. Oh my God, never mind. Then she tells me, "Well, Brutus is right." Right about what? He told me that we have a toxic relationship and I really need to break up with you because our relationship is unhealthy. What? This dude had the audacity to tell me the same exact advice that he was giving my girl behind my back. You're freaking dumb. Guys, I hope you do not feel this betrayal from a best friend, because that sucked. And it's still sucking. If you have an ex-girlfriend that cheated on you with your best friend, and your best friend backstabs you and goes out with your ex-girlfriend, you don't want that in your life. So after the breakup, that's when everything became very confusing. She told me that everything would have worked out fine if I didn't get too hurt. It's like I ruined her plan of her teaching me a lesson for hanging out with Missy, like having Missy as a friend. Like, that's like some psychotic... what? And after this whole breakup, she also tried to paint me as the bad guy, like she's the victim in all this, saying she has a reason why she cheated on me, and there was a reason why she became the way she became. Guys, that's so far from the truth. I don't know why she's saying that. When we were dating, I did everything for this girl. I spent so much money on her, guys. I got her jewelry, rings, bracelets, necklaces, and then I got her a lot of stuffed animals, flowers, like a lot of stuff. And I never expected anything in return. Just seeing her happy really made my day. It really did, guys, because she loved it when I bought her stuff. I just love seeing the people I care about happy. That's just who I am, especially if I made them happy. And it wasn't just the money, I also did a lot of big things for her too. I made a huge scavenger hunt throughout the whole school. I had clues underneath desks, inside of books in the library, underneath trash cans, and I even asked teachers to leave certain desks alone so I can hide some of the clues in there. At the end of the scavenger hunt was a big prize. Like, I just did that type of stuff for her. I always try to do random things to make her happy. I remember this one time where she was going on this camping trip and I really wanted to get her something. Her favorite color is purple and she loves Mickey Mouse. I was looking for a purple bag with Mickey Mouse on it. Turns out there was none that existed, so I made one for her. I literally bought a purple bag. I ironed on Mickey Mouse. I made her a camping survival kit bag out of scratch. Got a bunch of stuff in there. I got her a little first aid kit, Mickey Mouse headphones, EOS chapstick, pink Chiffon lotion, pink Chiffon hand sanitizer, the whole nine yards. I gave her a lot of stuff in there and I expected nothing in return. I just loved seeing her happy. And just at the end of the whole relationship, all I got was a cheating, backstabbing girlfriend who made out with my best friend. I don't understand. It still hurts a little bit because Brutus was my best friend. But guys, at the end of the day, there's gonna be people that really want to be in your life, and there's some people that just take you for granted, like Brutus and my ex. It gets better at the end. That pain in the pit of your stomach eventually goes away. I haven't felt that in a long time. I'm actually seeing a really hot, amazing girl. Yeah, it makes me smile a little bit. It gets better. Just throw away all the toxic people in your life. It's not worth it. But anyway, I hope you guys have a great, awesome, loving day. Please subscribe, like, and share. And thank you guys for over 100 subscribers. That's freaking awesome. Even though to some people that's a really small number, but that was my first goal and I reached it. And it's because of you guys. And my next goal is 1,000 subscribers. Get me up there. Please keep subscribing, liking, and sharing. And just have a wonderful day. Go dance. Go kiss a girl. Be stupid. Streak. I don't know. Bye, guys. See you guys next time. I don't give a fuck, I don't give a fuck, bitch. I don't give a fuck about you or anything that you do. Don't give a fuck about you or anything that you do. I heard you got a new man, I see you taking the pic. Then you post it up, thinking that it's making me sick. I see you calling, I be making it quick. I'ma answer that shit like I don't fuck with you. Bitch, I got no feelings to go. I swear I had it up to here, I got no feelings to go. I mean for real, fuck how you feel. Fuck it too, since if it ain't going towards the bill. Yeah, and every day.